Hello learners, so welcome to this particular section where I will be talking about the principles of social work. Principles of social work are the guiding assertions or the guidelines that help to achieve the objectives of this particular profession. So the first principle is principle of individualization. This principle asserts that we have to treat a client as a particular individual with differences or which are unique to the particular individual, and we have to respect that individuality of the particular client. The second one is principle of meaningful relationship. Without a relationship that is professional in nature and that is which has confidentiality and which has strength in the particular caseworker or the social worker, then until that it will not be a very effective social work session if the relationship is not built with the client. Therefore, it is a responsibility of the social worker to build up a meaningful relationship with the client. Third one is principle of self-determination. As we said that we empower the particular client through the social work profession. So this principle is a reflection of that particular ideology where we empower the client to make his or her own decisions. Therefore, it is known as self-determination of the client. Principle of acceptance. As a social worker or as a case worker, you have to accept the client as he is. You have to accept the client or the person who comes to help to you, seeking help to you. You have to be ready to accept the person with all the flaws, with all the difficulties, with the social background that he is coming from. Therefore, it is known as the principle of acceptance. Then, principle of communication. Communication is an important component of any profession, of any individual, the social life or, the personal life. So, communication component is actually indispensable to the social work profession. Without communication, there cannot be any help that can be given out to a particular client. And communication, we have to remember, is a two-way process. You will have to communicate well with the client. The client has to communicate well with you. Therefore, as we said, it builds up a meaningful relationship. And in that particular relationship with the client, there has to be effective two-way communication. Next is principle of empathy. What does the word empathy mean? Empathy means understanding the client's problem by standing in his shoes or understanding the perspective of the particular client from his way of him facing the particular circumstances. Therefore, empathy enables a social worker to understand the problem of the client from his or her perspective. Then comes the principle of social functioning. Here it means that as we individuals are part of the society, the individual has to learn how to effectively function in the society by changing certain aspects of the personality, the way a person thinks, and therefore the person is able to socialize in the particular social environment in which the client belongs to. This is known as social functioning, the ability to function well in the social environment. Next, we move to the principle of tuning behavior. Here it means that through the profession of social work, the social worker enables the client to tune his behavior or to change the perspectives or to change the way a person communicates with the social environment. It is known as tuning behavior or bringing about positive change in the behavior of the client. Then we go to the principle of social learning. The client will have to learn from the social environment. Social learning involves various processes, and the social worker is the main empowering agent that helps the client to learn from the social experiences. And then the principle of confidentiality. The word confidentiality means it is the responsibility of the social worker to preserve the confidence or the secret in information on maybe the sharing of feelings that the client shares with a particular caseworker or the social worker. It is building trust with the client. Only when the client is able to establish a meaningful relationship with the social worker has to respect the aspect that the client is sharing very personal information with the social worker. Therefore, as a social worker, we have to make sure that we apply this principle of confidentiality and we do not share any personal information with any of our, you know, allies or anyone in the same or maybe with your friends. You are not supposed to discuss your cases. That is the principle of confidentiality. Now, moving into the functions of social work, P.D. Mishra has categorized these four functions of social work. First one is curative or remedial. What does cure mean? It means that you are curing something or bringing or finding a solution to a particular problem. So under the curative function, these are the services, the medical service, the health service relating to psychosocial and mental health, psychiatric services, child guidance, child welfare services, or services provided to persons with disability and rehabilitative services. Here you see the beneficiaries are those who are undergoing certain kind of problem and they are seeking help from you. Therefore, through social work profession, you are trying to find a cure or a remedy to the particular problem. That is why it is known as curative or remedial function. The next one is correctional function. Here we see that the word correctional itself means you are going to correct or reform certain aspects of the particular client or any other social problem that you see. So bringing about correction or reform means here individual, there are three broad categories. The first one is the individual reform services, like a person staying in the prison, a prisoner on probation or parole, or other related services. So it means that the individual is trying to reform him or herself or bringing about a positive change. Therefore, it is a function of social workers. Services for strengthening and improving relationship, like certain families, there are where there is a problem between the couple, or when there is a problem with a child, there is a problem in the familial relationships, then this needs to be corrected or reformed. Then this is a correctional function of social work. Then also social problems like prevention of prostitution, beggary, prohibition services, removal of untouchability, or any other form of discrimination that you want to reform will come under the correctional function. Preventive function means that you are trying to prevent from certain problems to develop. Therefore, there is life insurances, public assistance, social legislation, labor welfare, all these come under preventive. That means when you try to prevent a problem from happening, those functions or those activities are known as preventive functions. The next one is developmental function. So as we know, another objective of social work is to promote social development. So to promote developmental activities, there are various aspects like socio-economic developmental activities, educational and recreational activities, urban and rural development programs, maybe from the government or any individual initiative or initiative from certain non-governmental organizations or groups. These are known as developmental functions where you promote social development through the social work profession. Now let us move on to the methods of social work. Social work has mainly six methods, and this is a very important part of social work profession. So once we learn the methods of social work, it will equip you to understand how you are going to help individuals, groups, communities in the society. So let us see, what is a method? A method can be defined as an orderly way of procedure which is always carried out towards the attainment of particular goals. So basically, it is a set of strategies, it is a set of skills, techniques, tools that will help you in dealing with the social issues. There are total 6 methods, and it is employed for the benefit of the clients or the specific target groups. The methods are casework, group work, community organization, social action, social welfare administration, and social work research. The first three, that is casework, group work, and community organization, are the primary methods of social work, while social action, social welfare administration, and social work research are considered to be the secondary methods of social work. Now let us discuss each method and see that what is meant by casework. Casework is practice of social work with individuals. So now we come to the micro level, where the micro unit of the society is the individual. Or here we will deal with the problems of individual, maybe in the familial aspect or in a small group of, where the individual is the main focus and not the group as a whole. So solving the individual problem is one of the main objectives of social work profession. Casework deals with the problems of the individuals, and it enables the social functioning of individuals and focuses on one-to-one relationship. When we try to analyze the problem of an individual, we will see that the individual mainly has problems in adjustment with the social environment. Therefore, as I told you, social functioning, which is a principle of social work, needs to be enhanced through the social work profession. Mary Richmond is one of the main propounders of social casework method. Her book Social Diagnosis elaborated on the method of casework and the significance. She has defined social casework as those processes which develop personality through adjustments continuously affected individual by individual between the individual and the social environment. So when we talk about casework, we have to keep two things in mind, that is the individual and the social environment. So when we are dealing with the individual problems, we are actually focusing on how the individual is dealing with his or her personal problems. It helps to deal with the issues of individuals of particular age, across gender, and across various sections of the society, and help in developing their social functioning. Next, we go to the method of group work. Group work is another primary method of social work, and it is an important one. Why? Because as we know, individual is a social animal. So we need the society to survive. And when we talk about society, what it is actually, it is nothing but a network of social relationships. So here, in casework, we focus on the individual. And in group work, we focus on the individual, how they behave within a particular social group. That is why it is known as group work. Sometimes we see that individual problems may not be solved through only individual counseling or casework. Then we go to the next level, where we bring about those individuals with similar problems together as a group. Now, when they come together as a group, they are more confident about their problem and how to go about it. So it leads to discussion, it leads to developing social relations, and social relations with those people who have similar problems. Therefore, group work goes to the next level of bringing about together those individuals who have similar problems. Group work is applicable in all settings of social work. It is that which uses group as a medium of therapy. Because suppose a very abused individual is dealing with the social discrimination and everything, and the person is brought together in contact with another individual who has similar problems, and in that way you bring about many individuals with similar problems together, they form a big support system. So this support system helps them in coping with their problem. Group work with groups of children, patients with similar health issues, or those who are addicted, those with life-threatening diseases who know that death is very near to them and they are not able to bear with the sorrow, with the trauma. Then what happens is you bring such individuals together. Those are vulnerable groups or people with disability, the aged who feel very lonely, or youth in a community who are maybe facing a lot of mental trauma because of unemployment or any other addiction or any kind of problem at home. So you bring such individuals. Suppose I bring a group of addicts together and now they have to find out a solution how they have to leave that particular addiction. So they are forming a support system within themselves and they are trying to find out problem for solution of this particular problem. Therefore, group work assists individuals to enhance their functioning in the society in a group setting, and it also results have shown that there is effective coping in the social environment when the individuals with common problems are brought together. Moving to the next primary method is community organization, and it involves mobilizing and empowering communities through their groups, leaders, advocacy, that means providing socio-legal help, then volunteers, institutions and organizations. It is a long-term process. Who are marginalized or living in poverty or any kind of problem, they are brought together. So what happens through the method of community organization is that there is intervention by the social worker, who is known as a community organizer, or the social worker belonging to a particular non-governmental organization or governmental organization. They direct the particular community how things can be achieved for their own development, for maybe community development or solving certain problems. Suppose in a particular community, there is a lot of alcoholism. So as a community, how will they come together to deal with this problem? So what happens is the social worker mobilizes all the community members to come together and to deal with the particular problem. Then you are connecting those community members to the resources. Suppose community dealing with huge poverty and unemployment, the social worker can connect the particular community to the resources provided by the government. So you will be the resource mobilizer, the guide, the support of that particular community. The community organizer has to be expertized in human relationships. In all the methods of social work or the profession of social work, you have to remember that building human relationship of trust, of being able to communicate well, is very important in this particular profession. Social action is a secondary method of social work, which focuses on the organized group processes to deal with general problems and enhancing social welfare by legislative, social or economic progress. Suppose there is any injustice that is taking place in society and you need to mobilize the community or action groups against that, then this is known as social action. It involves efforts to bring about change and prevent change in current practices. For example, when you talk about any social environment movement, then it gives the example of preventing the environmental damage. So what you are doing, you are mobilizing the community to deal with or to bring up solution for certain social evils and prevent those from happening. It is one of the most controversial and challenging methods of social work, because there is a very thin line between crossing the legal aspect and being within the legal jurisdiction in carrying out social action activities with the community. Social welfare administration, it as we see, the word itself, the term itself, consists of welfare as well as administration. So it basically focuses on management of resources for the objective of achieving social welfare. social welfare discourse has been changing from the charity-based to the rights-based approaches. So we know that earlier people used to give out things in charity and it was considered to be social welfare. Now this perspective is changing. We are more looking for the rights of the vulnerable groups and linking up of resources that is available in the society has become the priority. Social work dictionary defines administration social welfare administration as the method used by those who take administrative responsibility to determine organizational goals for a particular governmental organization in the welfare sector and allocate those resources to carry out program to coordinate activities by achieving those goals. So you have to monitor the resources, assess the necessary resources, and then bring about change in the society. Research is an important part of every profession or every discipline. Social work profession research skills are important since it is both a science and an art. As social workers, there is a lot of dependence on database. Without knowing the social reality, you will not be able to intervene in the problems of the individual, the group, or the community. Therefore, social work research is very important here. Empirical database is an important prerequisite of any social work intervention. Without knowing the social reality, you will not be able to bring about effective changes in the life of the individual, groups, or the community. Social workers continuously access data from multiple resources, files of the clients, individuals, and groups, and these are documented and recorded. So whenever you are dealing with any client or group or community, please make sure that you are documenting everything, because that documenting is actually nothing but you are making or creating data out of your lived experiences. Social work research draws heavily from such primary data as well as secondary data. Secondary data means data which is already available and might be of your help. Primary data is collecting direct data from the client, from the group, from the community. And now let us see, drawing from the methods of social work that we have discussed here, we'll see that the social work is a human service profession and has various fields. The methods of social work are applicable in the various fields, that is, the scope of social work are those where social work trainees and professionals get involved in different aspects. Now, when we say fields, it means the diverse areas in which social work profession is applicable. The first one is family and child welfare, medical and psychiatric social work, industrial social work or social work at the workplace, counseling, rural, urban, community development, criminology and justice, social welfare administration. Family and child welfare will concentrate on the unit of the individual and the family, solving their problems. Medical and psychiatric will concentrate on the mental health and the issues that the patient's family faces when a person is dealing with life-threatening diseases is very harmful for the mental health of the entire family unit. In which there is a patient who is dealing with a very serious issue, health issue. Therefore, here the role of medical social worker is very important in the present times. The panic and the counseling, and the panic that takes place within a family, connecting that particular family or the individual patient to the resources available is a huge task, and it is the role of the social worker here which is indispensable. There should be more promotion of medical social work, psychiatric social work in our country. And now going to industrial social work, because of the rising stress of workplace hazards, workplace stress, therefore social workers needs to be there also. Rural and community development, here we see that there are various schemes of the government, and also we have to concentrate on hygiene, then infrastructural development. All these aspects are looked into through the rural and urban community development. Criminology and justice, as we spoke in the functions of social work, that correctional social work, remedial social work are very important. So to bring a person into the mainstream society after going through the correctional process, it requires a huge transitional help, and that is provided by the social worker. Social Welfare Administration focuses on justified distribution of resources, maybe monetary, maybe infrastructural, or maybe any other resources like food, clothing, anything. So all these things are properly mitigated or properly channeled to the society, to the vulnerable groups, is made sure by the social workers. That is where we call that field as Social Welfare Administration. So now I hope this video gives you an idea about the particular scope, the objectives, the principles, the functions of social work, then the methods, the six important methods of social work are important to understand for any social worker. So these are the references or the important books that which will give you the basic idea about social work profession. P.D. Mishra's book will give you a very simple and clear understanding of the techniques, the tools, the objectives, principles, methods of social work. So I hope this video has been helpful to you all in understanding the basic aspects of social work. Thank you so much.